Alright guys, once again we're here in the van and we're on our way to the haunted house. And while we're going over there, just kind of like to let you know how this thing works here. First of all, my video vlogs here are generally about 4 to 7 days behind their actual film date. And the reason is, I don't have any time, guys. I do my video and talking on the road mostly. That is because when I get to where I'm going, I'm always busy. And I can't really mess around with the camera and stuff. But anyways, I'd like to give a shout out to JHMFD. Cool dude, man. We should hang out sometime. I love Florida. In fact, I'm going there this summer. Going out to Orlando. My favorite place to go when I'm in Florida, usually, because I love Disney World. So yeah, you know, I've been working on my marketing pretty heavily these days. I'm trying to get ready for the show this year, and I got a call from my buddy at Comcast today, and it looks like we might have some pretty good deals worked out on our vendor space through Comcast, which is fantastic, because basically I don't really have to handle the vendor space so much as, you know, trying to sell it and trying to book it and all that kind of stuff. All I have to do is make sure they're there, that I have vendor spaces, and that you know, they have the stuff that we say, like power and that kind of stuff. No problem, man. They sell it, I get it lined up. And they, the companies that buy it are actually using it for promotional space during my event. And so it's working out really well, much better than I ever anticipated, not to mention the fact that we are getting ready to produce our commercial finally for the 2011 Halloween event. And this is really the first time we've had a major television commercial in all the years we've done this. It's my first time for doing one. I'm producing the commercial, shooting it myself, and editing and doing everything as I do at Hysteria City most of everything, including our radio commercials and all of our graphics for all of our ads and all of our graphics for all of our graphics. I do everything now. So anyway, coming to you live from Springfield, Oregon, the one and only hot guy going to the haunted houses right now. Alright guys, I'm tell you the truth, I'm a little bit afraid right now. Got the manager of the clown house following me, and it's not a good thing.
Come here, boy!
I think he's actually a little psycho.
You coming out this year? You better come! Now get that camera out of my face!
We're here to take you on a journey through the time machine. And I'm going to tell you this, you better be ready.
Alright guys, what Jack is displaying here is a Tyvek suit. And I scored a whole bunch of these guys today, and they come complete with the cool boots right there, and they're really kind of neat, and I don't know, they can be used in a lot of applications for Halloween. I'm sure you can probably think of something. Anyways, I'm gonna give some of these away as prizes here real soon. In fact, for the two contests I have going on right now, they're gonna go in the bundle And I say bundle because for the best video prize, I'm going to give away a whole set of Telematronics Illusion DVDs that includes fire faces and all different kinds of things for your haunted house that we make specifically for our haunted houses. And I'm going to give you, I'm going to give you two of these Tyvek suits plus the boots, that's right. And I'm going to give them all to you in a cool one of these designer Hysteria City coffins that we make. And I'll give you a couple tickets to the Halloween event. And I'll see if I could even throw in a Hysteria City t-shirt if they come in in time for this contest. But otherwise, I'm just going to put together a cool little package. We'll call it the Hysteria City Coffin Package for the winner of my YouTube contest that I got going on right now. And one of them is Poltergeist. The other one is Old Hunters Never Die. They just, you answer the question, get some stuff right here from Hysteria City. Ah!
Ghost Town Records presents A Haunted House. Ishmael, Shane Ali.
Yo, I hold it down for the ghost town, blazing the spot. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we are. And behind me, we've got the Clown Asylum. Signed way up there now. But yeah, the Clown Asylum is coming together. You can see we've got the steel look going on it, on all the trim. And soon I'm getting ready to put the windows on it with the bars. And we're going to have clown paraphernalia hanging out of the windows. And really we're trying to go with the asylum look that has really contained clowns. So it's not like tents and, you know, circus stuff. It's going to be like asylum stuff with clowns. More of a mental institution for the mentally insane clowns that we have here. Watch out. It's going to be real scary. Right here at Hysteria City. And as we enter on this side of the Clown Asylum, which is over here, now you can see that we have this nice little hallway between the time machine right there, which is looking awesome. Getting ready to trim it out and add its little functional details. We're going to do some spinning cogs and steam, and it's real steampunk, so it's going to be pretty cool over here. And of course, next door, the Clown Asylum. Flashbacks of the scene in my living room. As I sit on my couch, peeping out with this news. The streets is full of blood, like dirty water in the gutter. And the killer even took the massacre a little further. To grab it for TV, cause when you cross me, see, I see you as a hell from the shops of this Uzi.
Even the creeps and the ghouls love the people we do. This is Ghost Town Records, and we are on the loose. I'm telling the grim tale, raising as much, tell us the next.
Alright, guys, so we got it. Put in the street signs and the street lights, and that's what Jack's doing right now, kind of helping to get the street lights put in place so that we can get them installed. And we had a little problem. I had got a new control box. We were updating our control system for the lighting this year, and I had a new one, and we hooked it up hoping that we would have all of our flicker circuits working throughout the rest of the haunt over on this side over here. And it didn't work. It was sad, it didn't work. And but anyways, we got a new control box from them. It didn't work, and it's because it's a new control box. The program wasn't right on an old program. So they're making us a brand new program. They're gonna send it out to us. Sounds back there. And so we can make this thing happen here and get this thing flickering and lit up like we want it to be. And that's going to happen real soon. What the hell's going on back there? Oh, it's Jack. Put your damn shirt on, man. That's the scariest thing around here. My God. JHMFD, alias Handjob. You like him. Look at that. There you go. From animated lighting. That's what we've been using for several years for the Christmas shows and for our Halloween shows. And they have some great systems that can be programmed. You can do all kinds of stuff with their lighting systems. But we use theirs primarily to do our flickering circuits and our lightning and various shows that we put on that come to life and make the haunts come to life every so often. time machine light, man. Wow. Well, Jack, what do you think, man?
I'm loving it, bro. I'm just sick. Is it? It'll scare the crap out of people.
Well, it's looking kind of industrial around here, that's for sure, looking through the viewfinder.
Extremely industrial, man. Major steel.
Wow.
Lots of gold. Put a lot into this, you guys. You're gonna love it.